the prep pursuit. I'm Devereaux Walton, a modern etiquette, image, and style expert. I'm also a consultant where I serve busy working professionals around the world, helping them advance their companies and careers. If you're interested in learning more about my etiquette and image consulting services, please visit thepoisedpursuit.com. Today's video is work email etiquette, all about how to professionally send emails when you are at work. This is important because we all know that emails are exchanged and sometimes they are sent on to someone else or they leave an impression. They come up over and over again. So be careful with your emails. Now, I've got 5 tips for you for your work email etiquette, so let's get started. The first tip for work email etiquette is to use an appropriate subject line. Now, it's really confusing to just send an email with no subject line or a subject line that's just not at all relevant. Personally, it is a pet peeve of mine if someone sends me an email about work, a project, or something, and I have no idea what the email is when I'm looking at it in my inbox because there's just no subject. It's blank. Someone just did that to me a few weeks ago, actually. It was a team that I'm working with to collaborate with them on their podcast, and someone sent me an email with just no subject, and I was just wondering, what is this email about, because it had no subject line. So don't let that happen to you. Send your work emails with an appropriate subject line every single time. Now, the second work email etiquette tip is to include an appropriate greeting. You also want to include the person's name. So maybe it's good morning, John, or dear Jane, but you don't want to just start a message without acknowledging the person. It's rude and it's just not in good taste. So always include a greeting and someone's name at the beginning of your emails. Now, the third work email etiquette tip pretty much goes without saying, but I tried to think about what I could talk about in this video, and I really thought this one would be a given. I don't need to tell you that you should not include profanity or foul language in your work emails, do I? But it does tend to happen more commonly than it should. So it's in the video. Number 3, work email etiquette. Please do not use foul language or profanity. Now, again, when you send an email message, it's not just going to the recipient. It's staying on the server. It's likely to get forwarded or printed. There are all these options that people have to do with the messages that you send them. So be mindful, because you don't want to send someone a message that will be broadcasted at another time and really cause a conflict in your career. The 4th email etiquette tip for work email etiquette is to keep your messages clear and concise. If you can, use bullet points, use spaces between different paragraphs to really just separate and organize the information. And please, if you can, avoid using the reply all unless everyone on that email chain needs the message. It's very, very common for people to forget this and they reply all, and a message that should just go to a few people is now going to 10 or more, hundreds or even thousands of people. So when you are replying to a message, be mindful that you don't hit reply all unless you absolutely need to. The 5th and final work email etiquette tip is to avoid using personal topics, having personal conversation in your work email. Again, this is on a server. These emails are saved. You do not want to have emails you're sending with gossip, rumors, personal information about yourself or your friends or family, not at work. Just avoid doing that because it's highly unprofessional. So if you're going to talk about personal things with colleagues at work, send it through personal email accounts or maybe text messages, but avoid using your work email for your personal life and personal relationships and details. It's a work email account and it should only be used for work. Now, I hope you found these work email etiquette tips helpful, and if you've got one I did not mention, feel free to share it. Share it in a comment below because I'd love to see your work email etiquette tips, and if I did not include one because this video does not include all email etiquette tips for work, please feel free to share. Thank you for watching the video today, and before you go, if you're new to the channel, please do subscribe. I share videos every single week about etiquette, style, and life to help you thrive personally and professionally. Thank you for stopping by the channel today to watch this video, and I look forward to seeing you again in another one. Bye for now.